Number one, how much does it cost to move? Well, we can start with the obvious, it depends, but it depends on a few items. Like when you're moving, where you're moving from and to, and what services other than actual transportation will you be buying. Now, our local moves are charged by the hour, not by weight. Now, your price will be based on the number of crew and trucks used to facilitate your move. Charges start when the truck and team leave the warehouse and end when they arrive back, because we charge for the whole time that they're in the service of your move. Now, while rates vary from time and location, most customers can expect to pay between $1,800 and $3,300 for a local move. Now, they can be higher too, depending on what services you need and how extensive your move, and they can also go lower than this, although all moves are subject to a minimum amount, depending on the location. Interstate moves, however, are charged by weight and distance, and they use a tariff to match the weight and distance of your shipment to a rate that will be used in the case of a non-binding estimate. So in a non-binding estimate, it means that while we give you an estimate of the price, we will charge you once we get an actual weight of your shipment. This price could be higher or lower than the estimate. Alternatively, you could opt for a binding estimate, and that bases the price on the inventory and the scope of services that you need. As long as the inventory matches what is moved and the estimated scope matches what is performed, then you'll know your price before you move. It is binding, meaning unchangeable. And there are pros and cons to each binding and non-binding estimate types, which you can learn more about on our website. We've written extensive articles in our Learning Center about this topic specifically. But returning to price, it can vary widely, but most people can expect to pay between $3,500 and $7,000 for an interstate move. Now, our peak season can increase these rates, and other services that you might want to add can add to the price too. That price can also be lower, but again, it's subject to minimums. Now, we calculate the price using many variables. To do this, we're going to send out an estimator to help compile an inventory of what needs to be moved and help estimate the required time and get you a final estimated price. Now, when we give you this price, we expect it to be the best we can provide you. Sometimes customers ask, is the price negotiable? Still, we won't be charging you extra, expecting you to haggle with us. We're not used car salesmen. We're going to give you the best price we can up front based on our inventory of your items and the type of estimate you need. Now, suppose this price is outside your budget range or comes in higher than you want it. In that case, there are typically some different revisions that can be done, such as reducing items to move, doing some work yourself, or eliminating an extra service. Your estimator can work with you and your specific circumstance to give you the best possible arrangement. Still, we will not try and gouge you, expecting you to haggle back. We try to provide you with our best price up front because we believe in being honest. Lastly, let us stress that we can never issue a binding estimate or even promise any rates without firm move dates and a book move. And this is because our price is dependent on the demand for our services. For example, during the summer, when everybody wants to move, prices are higher and they change quickly. Therefore, by the time you book with us, the rates might have changed from what was quoted. And if you're looking to move during that time, work with your estimator to know if prices change quickly and factor into that into your decision. Once you're on the books though, your price is locked in unless you opt to change the scope or the inventory.